Hello, I'm Meli for Edu4Java and this is tutorial number 8. Instructions or sentence 4. We are also going to take a look at arrays. Let's start with this example, which we have already seen. A 4 which iterates from 0 to 2, printing the numbers 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. If someone has any doubt, please take a look at the last tutorial about while. This same while can be done in another way. It can be done with a for. Let's use this for by default, which Eclipse gives us. Not this, because it is used for arrays. Let's write 3. And we write CISO print line. Run. This does exactly the same thing as what we saw before. Why? For is an iteration instruction just as the while. It has its block, which is similar. What is different is what there is inside the parentheses. Inside the condition of a while, there is a condition, and inside a for, there are three parts separated by a semicolon. The first part is the initialization. The second is the condition, just as the while, and the third one, which is the part of incrementation. These three parts are going to be executed in different moments. This part, initialization, will be executed before cycling. If we compare it with a while, it's very similar. This is executed just once before it starts cycling. Here it is just the same. What we write here is going to be executed just once. Here we can put more instructions, but basically this is executed once. This second one is similar to the other one. It is a condition. While it is true, this will be executed. If it's false, it goes out. This last one is as if we wrote it at the end of the block. It will be executed if it goes into the block and as the last instruction of the block, just as it executed here. This is why it does the same. Let's run it once again so you can see. To see a more real example, we're going to add an array. Int square brackets array between braces. Two, three, five, seven, one. Okay, this is the declaration of an array. With this, we create a variable called array, which belongs to the type array of int. An array of int is like a chest of drawers. Imagine that every drawer is an int type variable. We could imagine that the int array as a chest of drawer of ints. Automatically here we set what it has inside. This is a way of writing an array constant of int type. The elements are written in between braces and separated by commas. Here we have an array with 2, 3, 5, 7, 1. The for is specially good for this. With just one click, I have an iterator that goes from 1, e equals 0 till the length of the array. The object array has a variable length. With this, we can go through the array. Let's print it on the console, so you can see it. To enter the positions of the array, we have to write the name of the variable of the array and the position inside the chest of drawers. If we wrote 0, we would enter the position 0. Let's do it this way so you can see it better. Let's comment this. And if we print the position 0, 2 is going to be printed. Why? Because there is a 2. In the position 4, we have a 1. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. In the position 3, we have a 7. 0, 1, 2, 3. In the position 5, we have an error. We had said that the chest of drawers started in 0 and finished in the length of the array minus 1. It goes from 0 to 4. When we try to enter the position 5, it's a door that doesn't exist. That's why it gives us an error. This is very nice, but we don't win a lot with this. Better with this. Notice that if we change the position 0 to I and we go around the numbers between 0 and the array minus 1, because when I is the same as the array, it is not going to execute it. With just one instruction, we're going to run it several times. The first time it goes into the cycle, I is equal 0, and it enters the position 0, which is 2, so it prints 2. The second time it equals 1. So the array in the position 1 is equal to 3. It prints 3, and the same with 5, 7, and 1. What else can I do to show you the use of this? Let's see. This has a big advantage if there are a lot of numbers. Here, there are just 5, but imagine that there are hundreds of them. Let's write some more so you can see. So that it gets more clear. We run it. If we had to do this by hand, we would have to write system.out for each of them, imagine. If there were hundreds, we would have to write hundreds of lines. We are saving a lot of lines with only 3 of them. We will have to do with hundreds of them. This is the functionality of an array. And the 4. Let's write something more interesting. Instead of printing in this way, we are taking out the in and we're going to put a comma. See, you can see that there are printed one after the other. Now we're going to increment in 1 all the elements of the array. This is what is written here. Incrementamos en 1, increment in 1. For, we write another 4 to iterate. And we can put the same print to see how it looks. Here the first ones are printed Then the second ones are printed, but they're the same. We should increment them in the middle. We're going to change it now. Let's do another 4. And we're going to do it for each of the elements. Array E, we're going to assign. Let's use the operator incremental so that we get used to it. Let's get each of the elements and we're going to add them 1. That's what the incremental operator does. So let's run it again. Here you can see the first printing, which was generated by this 4. After we wrote that we're going to increment in 1, we do a 4 for that for each element we're going to add 1. First the position 1, which is 2, and we're going to increment 2 in 1. 3 plus 1 and 5 plus 1, and we do the same and print it. This is very simple, but it is so that you get the concepts of array and for, which are used a lot in Java. In the next tutorial, we're going to see for and array too, but with a bit more complicated example. Play with this exercise until you feel comfortable with an array. Play with a 4 too. You can change the variables, for example, this for a 2. And you're going to see that all the work is done from here onwards. Okay, practice a bit, but the next one is a bit more complicated. See you in the next tutorial. Bye.